Well, I think to sum it up in one sentence, the Pistons are heading into the same direction as Detroit's economy. Right into a shithole. I probably shouldn't make jokes like that because people are actually losing their jobs and, you know, their homes. It's okay. I'm going to hell anyways, so might as well enjoy my ride there. All right, off-season review. So the Detroit Pistons didn't have much cap space this summer. So as expected, they didn't make many moves in free agency. They signed both Zaza Pachulia and Jose Calderon to minimum deals. They signed Glenn Robinson III to 2 years and $8.3 million. And of course, they got Dwayne Casey as their new head coach. And in free agency, they lost Anthony Tolliver and then James Ennis. In the draft, they drafted Kyrie Thomas with the 38th overall pick and then Bruce Brown with the 42nd overall pick. Kyrie Thomas is a 6'3" shooting guard who I think has the potential to be a 3-and-D type player, but unfortunately nothing more than that. He's got a very good 3-point shot, very active and pesky on defense, and he has some playmaking ability, driving and dishing, but most of his scoring comes from spot-ups. And I think in the NBA, he's gonna have a hard time creating separation. But because of his shooting and his defense, he should be a player that could come in and maybe contribute right away this season. Bruce Brown is a bit harder to define as a player. He's got the size of a shooting guard, but plays more like a point guard or more like a ball-handling small forward. The big problem with him is that he can't really shoot, which is not good given his size. You're talking about attempting 3 threes per game last year from college range and only hitting 26.7%. That's not very good. Granted, his mechanics look pretty decent, and during summer league, he's shown that he can hit it from time to time. Another problem is that he's not that explosive, so you also wonder how he'll do attacking NBA defenses. And like mentioned, he does play like a point guard in the sense that he is a very, very good passer. Nothing extraordinarily flashy, but he makes the right plays. To be honest, I'm not very excited about either Thomas or Brown. If only you could mesh their skill sets together, you'd have like a future all-star, but unfortunately, you can't do that. I'm pretty neutral about both James Ennis and Glenn Robinson III. I mean, I think at this point in their respective careers, they're probably comparable, so the replacement is fine by me. Signing Zaza Pachulia and Jose Calderon is meh. I mean, like most Pistons fans, I really wish that they actually kept Anthony Tolliver, who's really been the glue guy of this Pistons team for like 3 of the last 4 years, you know, not counting the year before when he was in Sacramento. And then let's talk about them hiring Dwayne Casey. This is really tough because with Dwayne Casey on the surface, it seems like getting the reigning coach of the year is a home run deal. But I have to bring into question what Casey is there for. I mean, is Casey there to try to make this team a contender or develop the young players? I suppose you could say both. I trust Casey with the latter. I don't really trust him with the former. And from his press conference, it sounds like he's all in on the former. This is a quote he said. I'm telling the guys now, we're not developing. We're not 2 or 3 years away. We want to win right now. Dwayne Casey has actually only been a head coach for 6 years, which is not that long in the NBA, and all 6 with the same franchise and the same star players. So it's hard to know what he'll even do in Detroit. You know, after all, having Blake and Drummond as your 2 best players is very different than having Lowry and DeRozan as your 2 best players. Overall, I'm giving the Pistons an offseason grade of a C. While I would grade the moves themselves somewhere around a B-, taking into context where this franchise is, I thought this offseason was pretty terrible. I'm of course talking about the sort of no man's land situation the Pistons are in. You've probably heard of this talked about in other teams and other situations before, but the basic concept is this. When a team has no hope at winning a championship, check that box for Detroit. When a team doesn't have a player that is a number one option on a championship team, check that. When a team does not have a young player that has the potential to be that type of superstar level player, check that. When a team isn't terrible enough to outright tank for high draft picks, check that. When a team has very stranded cap space moving forward and thus limited options improving the team through free agency, check that. That's the Detroit Pistons. They check off basically all the boxes of a team that is stuck in no man's land. Take a look at their projected roster. Look, don't get me wrong. I think the Pistons are going to be fighting for a playoff spot. Dwayne Casey is also the type of coach that would relentlessly push his players towards that goal. And even though on paper, it looks like the Pistons got worse, I think they'll actually be better this season than last season, given that Blake will have more time to fit in, and Kennard and Stanley Johnson could both take a jump in production. Blake Griffin is probably still the deciding factor as to this whole season. I mean, he had a pretty bad first 10 to 12 games with the Pistons, but his last 13 games with the Pistons was much better when he was shooting threes at a high percentage, like he did in the beginning of the season with the Clippers. Here's the deal with Blake Griffin taking threes, by the way. Even though 34% from three is not great by any stretch of the imagination, 34% from three is still better than 48% from mid-range, statistically. So you'd rather Blake take these threes than those awful-looking long twos. His defense with the Pistons was pretty consistently bad. It's not like he was ever great to begin with. And that's going to be a problem. I don't know if Blake can really get better defensively at this point in his career, but maybe Dwayne Casey could just implement a better overall system that perhaps has Blake Griffin doing less on defense. Vegas odds has the Pistons at 38 wins. Now, this might surprise many of you because throughout this entire video, I've been pretty negative on the Pistons. I've been pretty harsh on them, but I'm actually going to take the over on this one. The Pistons went 11-14 with Blake, all right? And this is obviously imperfect math, but if you stretch that out to 82 games, that's around 36 wins. Whatever Dwayne Casey is in the playoffs, you have to admit he's a great regular season coach. If they can get 70 games out of Blake this next season, not a guarantee at all, but if they can get at least 70 games out of him, I think they can hit 38 wins, but probably no more than like 43 or 44, which means they'll end up somewhere between the 6th and 10th seed. Again, this is a pretty terrible place to be as a franchise, given what Detroit's roster and cap space looks like, but there really isn't any easy solution either way. After all, you traded for a guy who's making $35 million per year over the next 4 years. You're paying Andre Drummond and Reggie Jackson a combined $44 million per year for the next 2 years. If your top three players are all overpaid, that's gonna put a huge limit on how good your team can be. All right, that's it for today's video. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for the other season previews. They're coming up. I'm still grinding through these. And I'll see you guys in hell.
Peace.